Right now, the U.S. is seeing a startling rise in hate crimes against Asian Americans. Police attribute almost all of those crimes to the coronavirus pandemic. And you may recognize actor George Takei from his years as Mr. Sulu in the original Star Trek TV series and movies. But in his memoir, They Called Us Enemy, Takei takes us inside his real-life childhood as a prisoner in an American internment camp for people of Japanese descent during World War II. It is a sobering story that began with Takei just 4 years old and born in the U.S., being forced along with his family from their home, shipped to relocation centers, and held for years under armed guard. George Takei joins us now. George, it's so nice to have you on the show. It really is. And you obviously have such an important perspective, experience, voice on this issue. With everything you went through as a child, what is it like now to be going through this rise in attacks on Asian Americans?
Well, thank you for the invitation. Yes, this is very, very concerning. And it's terrorizing in many sectors of this country. Asian American hate has been as organic to American history, not as long as discrimination against African Americans that began in 1619, but it's been a steady ferment in the United States from the very first Asian that came to this country about in the middle of the 19th century. That was the Chinese coming first. And in my hometown of Los Angeles, back in 1871, there was a case where a white woman complained about being harassed by a Chinese man. And very quickly, a vigilante mob formed, poured into Chinatown, at random dragged out 17 Chinese, young Chinese men, and they strung them up in the Central Plaza of Los Angeles from this giant tree. That plaza is still there. It's a historic monument. But 17 Chinese were lynched there back in 1871. And so whenever there is an incident against Asians, it surges up. And as you noted in my introduction, when Japan bombed Pearl Harbor, and we're Americans. My mother was born in Sacramento. My father was born in Japan, but he was brought to San Francisco when he was a young boy, and he was educated and reared in San Francisco. And so he was Japanese in birth only, but he was of Japanese ancestry. After the bombing of Pearl Harbor, this xenophobic hysteria swept across the country, and that hysteria reached even the presidency of the United States. And I don't know what it is with.
This is, there we go.
Sorry about
that. Nice save. No, we're all used to these technical issues in the era of COVID.
We are in the COVID technological. Sometimes sound goes out. But the president of the United States, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, signed an executive order ordering all people of Japanese ancestry on the West Coast, approximately 120,000 of us, which I happen to be one, to be summarily rounded up at gunpoint and imprisoned in barbed wire prison camps. And I remember my experiences in three of those camps. We were first sent to the horse stables of Santa Anita because the camps weren't built yet. So we were imprisoned in a horse stall. Can you imagine? Three children and my parents in a horse stall until for about 3 or 4 months. And then we were shipped out to the swamps of Arkansas. They were all in the most desolate and godforsaken places in this country. And we were there for about a year and a half and then transferred to another camp in Northern California. Here it is again.
No.
Something's wrong with this. And so now the president that came before President Biden during the pandemic continued to refer to the pandemic or the virus as the Chinese virus or the Wuhan virus or Kung flu, and just agitated, and it came to a head again, surging, and Asian Americans were, innocent Asian Americans had nothing to do with it, were victimized by these hate attacks. In San Francisco, an elderly Asian man, I think he was 81, was walking down the sidewalk, and this 19-year-old boy came running toward him at full speed down the sidewalk and smacked him down on the sidewalk with such impact that he was killed, he died.
Yeah, and I mean, there's so many other horrific examples. And in New York, you saw we just heard about this incident there where an Asian man was stabbed in the torso, went right through his liver. I mean, it's just, there's
no... Or a woman set on fire.
A woman said, I mean, it is disgusting. There is no excuse for this. What has the personal experience been like for you? I mean, are you concerned about leaving your house now and just walking down the sidewalk? I mean, we've heard from many people who are now even afraid of doing simple daily activities because of what we're seeing.
Well, we are strict observers of the quarantine protocols, so we don't leave the house. Only once a day do we leave the house, and that's at 6:30 in the morning when we go off for our 45-minute walk in the neighborhood, and we live in a very safe neighborhood, Hancock Park. So that's the only time we expose ourselves to that. But it is really frightening, and I can't imagine people who live in other neighborhoods, Asian Americans, going out. That we are fearful of going out and being victimized. And it is random, it is senseless, it is irrational, and it is terrifying. And then, some people have been killed.
It just makes your blood boil. It's just so awful. But George Takei, thank you for coming on and lending your voice to this really important issue that's happening right now in our country.